Rabita Education Award na ee karyakramadalli I think I better switch over to English. Guest of honor of the today's program, Janab Zafariab Jilani Sahab. The president of the today's program, Janab Zahid Ruknuddin Sahib. And just now you heard the report of the Rabita Education Award ceremony, my friend Janab Yunus Ghazia Sahab, friends who have accompanied me, Mr. Nivedit, Mr. G.A. Bawa, our IGP, Mr. Arun Chakrabarti, and all the dignitaries who are on the dais, and members of the Rajita Education Trust and all the members of the Jamaat, my brothers and sisters of Bhatkal and friends from the media. My best of the greetings to all of you this evening. I have come here to Bhatkal after a long time. I have come here before along with my political guru, Janab S.M. Yahya Sahab. In 87-88, after I returned from Australia after my education, Yahya Sahab knew my father very well. One day when I met him in Bangalore, he asked me, "Why don't you join politics?" I laughed at him. He said, "No, I am not joking. I am very serious that you should join politics." He persuaded me almost one and a half years. And finally he succeeded in registering me as a primary member of the Congress Party. And he took me to Delhi. He introduced me to another political mother of mine, Srimati Mohsina Kidwai. She is my political mother. I call her political mother to me. And later on, I was introduced to Rajiv Gandhi, then the Prime Minister. And the journey started in politics. I became an MLA 5 times. I became a minister many times. And I was a member of the working committee of the Congress in Delhi. And then came back and became a president of the Congress Party almost 8 years. So the entire credit of my journey goes to my political guru, S.M. Yahya. I visited this place. I almost cried because I remember when he used to bring me here, we used to sleep. I used to sleep in the same house. And his mother was there quite aged then. And we used to take the blessings from her. So this is the memory of Bhatkal for me. So when I was called to this program, I said, whatever happens, I will attend this program today. And I have come here exclusively to attend this program. Friends, I must congratulate the Rabita Education Trust because all of you, majority of the members who are NRIs, who would like to see their children, her brothers and sisters, to get educated and also lead a peaceful, successful life in future. And I saw the list of the awardees who have taken 97-98%. The children who have taken 97-98%. I congratulate them for their efforts. See, education is something which changes an individual. Not only changes an individual outward, but also inside of an individual. Our forefathers emphasized that education is the only thing in our country to change the people's mind. In fact, Lord Macaulay, when he came here to India, he commented that Indians should not be given a professional education. The reason being, Indians are bright, Indians are talented, Indians can succeed in any situation. Well, they couldn't stop Indians becoming professionals. I can tell you today, India produces the finest technical manpower in the world. Many of you are in Middle East, you all know how successful Indians, including yourselves. Today India produces 70,000 doctors per year. 70,000 doctors per year. More than 5 lakh engineers in various faculties per year. And lakhs of graduates in hundreds of universities which we have started after independence. Today you go to any country in the world, you find Indian engineers, software engineers particularly. You go to any country in the world, you find an Indian doctor, maybe in many specialties. You go to universities in the United States or in the Europe, you find a lot of university professors, head of the departments, working in those universities. You go to international judiciary, you find Indian judges, Indian law professors, Indian law experts occupying various positions. The other day I visited International Law of Justice at The Hague. There were many Indians who occupied many positions there. How did this all of a sudden happen after independence? People today criticize X party, Y party, political affiliations. But as Indians, we have achieved something. Just in 71 years, we are able to compare ourselves to the United States of America, which has 250 years of independence history. I still remember in 60s when I was in school, 70s, we were given care food, which used to come from United States for America, which Mrs. Indira Gandhi used to get. In schools, we were given milk, powdered milk. We had no food. In 60s and 70s, early 70s, we had shortage of food in India. In 1982, I attended an International Botanical Congress in Sydney, Australia. There were more than 4,500 scientists from all over the world. And in that conference, they declared that India today reached self-sufficiency in food grains. We were no more beggars. We could even export food grains to other countries in the world. For your information, today India exports large number of items in the food chain as food grains and other prepared commodities in the food chain to the rest of the world. Are we not proud of it? I ask my friends from the BJP, I ask my friends who criticize the Congress party, have we not achieved? Has our people, Indians, have not achieved, irrespective of any political affiliation, irrespective of any religion, any caste, any color, any creed, have we not achieved? This is the question that people in India should know and should answer. I always wonder, how did this happen? Is it a magic that we created? Or is it the hard work and the mindset of Indians who suffered for more than 200 years under the British rule, wherein we were not even called as Indians, India as a country? And today, we are Indians, we are a country. United, whatever may be the differences. I recall 1947, 14th August 1947, Pakistan got an independence. 15th of August, India got an independence. 14th, when they hoisted the flag of Pakistan, they declared it as an Islamic state. But when 15th India hoisted a flag, India declared as Bharat, India, Hindustan. It didn't call itself that Hindus country. The constitution came subsequently, and in the constitution, Dr. Baba Saheb Ambedkar has written, you may be of any religion, any background, you can practice it in India. You can practice your religion in India. Be you are a Hindu, Muslim, Christian, Sikh, or Buddhist, or Jain, or whichever religion you belong to. This is the beauty of India. Constitution of India has given us everything, every right. Today we have a right to speak. Many countries you cannot speak freely. Many countries you don't have a right to do this, do that. You're controlled. But India is a free country. Unfortunately, in the today's scenario, people think otherwise. People think they want to polarize. People think only they can rule, they can live, they can eat, they can do whatever they want. Friends, it's not going to happen that way. India, in spite of diversity, it is going to be as India, as united, irrespective of any religion or caste or color you belong to. And that is what we have to do today. And for that, we need to educate our children more than anything, more than you give them money, more than you give them jewelry. You need to educate them so that all this differentiation is forgotten and we try to live within the diversified society as a united society. I don't want to take too much time because I have to leave earlier. And at the same time, I would like to leave out a message to all those children who are going to get these awards. You have a bright future. India is fast progressing. Karnataka is fast progressing within India. Bangalore, I'll include Mangalore as well, is the fastest growing society. Bangalore is considered as one of the most dynamic cities in the world. That means you have plenty of opportunities there to build your career, to build your life. You have great opportunities. I'm sure these children will make use of that. Our universities also give an opportunity, be it medical, engineering or general education. Our Jilani Saab is sitting here. The legal profession today is fine-tuning itself. It's no more evening college LLB. It is LLB 5 years course and a quality LLB. Our advocates can go and participate in any international arbitration. They can compete anywhere in the world. So those are the opportunities these children are going to get. So friends, I'm extremely happy to participate today. I wish to come back again at some point of time, spend some time in Bhatkal with all of you, or maybe eat a little bit more biryani. So tasteful. Today, yeah, I saw the slip. We have to leave now. They already slips are coming. Yeah. So, Yunus Saab has given me wonderful lunch. I'll come back again and eat more, definitely. And I wish you, every one of you, please don't feel insecure. Please don't feel insecure. We are brothers. We have come out to this world as brothers and sisters. and we will die as brothers and sisters. Please don't be afraid of anybody or any situation. You belong here, you don't belong anywhere else. Have that commitment, have that courage to live here peacefully. Our government here now in Karnataka is a coalition government, as you all know. But I represent the Indian National Congress. We are wedded. Indian National Congress is wedded for the secularism in this country. We will uphold that. We will definitely uphold that principle. Lastly, I remember my guru, S.M. Yahya. Till my last breath, I remember him and I pray my respects to him. Thank you very much for giving me this opportunity. Ellarigu namaskara.